In this video, we'll create scenarios to determine whether you should pursue a project, create a full loan schedule, and calculate how much you need to buy your dream car, all using Excel's financial formulas. And to apply these formulas, we'll be using our latest startup idea, a lemonade stand, so let's get into it, and try not to skip around so you don't get lost. So our plan is to work on this lemonade stand project for 4 years, as that's the time we'll be in university, after which we'll get a full-time job. But we're not quite sure if this is right for us, so first we need to determine how financially viable it is. But because we're not quite sure what our cash flows will look like, we actually created three different scenarios, a best case, a base case, and a worst case. And obviously in year zero it's going to be negative, that's because we need to have startup investments, right? Whether that be a lemonade stand, whether that be the equipment, and so on, after which we'll hopefully start to generate money. Now we'll use the choose formula on Excel to be able to change scenarios instantly. So for that, up here on the choose scenario, we would type the 1, the 2, and the 3, and that would hopefully give us these different cash flows. So let's press 1 for now, and from there, down over here, we'll go equals, choose, press the tab key, the index number is going to be the scenario that we want to choose, and then press the F4 key as that's going to lock it for us, press the comma key, the value number 1 is the best case, the value number 2 is the base, and the third one is the worst case. Close the brackets, press enter, and then from there you'll go control C and then move it across to the other side, control V, and now you're going to have all the different cash flows for the scenario number 1, as you can see here. If we change that to scenario number 2, then that's going to change to these ones over here. And just to make sure somebody doesn't put anything silly like a 4 in here, which is actually just going to break the cash flows for us, we're going to do a data validation. So for that, just go to Alt-A-V-V. And from there, you're going to put allow a list, because that's what we want. And the numbers we're going to want is just 1, 2, and 3. 1, 2, 3. Press the enter key. Now you're going to see that you can only press the different scenarios that you have here from the drop-down list. In case somebody tries to put something else, like a 4 here, you're going to see that they get a pop-up sign. So that's what we want. All right, so to assess whether the project is viable under scenario 2, which is the base case scenario, all we got to do is go alt equals, and that's going to sum the cash flows for us. And if it's positive, that's good to go. But unfortunately, that's not quite right, and that's because of this concept called the time value of money, which basically says that a dollar today is worth more than a dollar in the future. That's because you can invest that dollar and hopefully grow it over time. And so if you have a dollar in the future, you actually need to discount it back to the present value, and for that we'll use the discount rate. And the formula that we'll use to discount these cash flows is called the NPV, which is short for the net present value. So let's go equals, NPV, press the tab key, from there the rate is the discount rate that we got. Press the comma key, the value number 1. It's actually going to be from year 1 to year 4. Get those values. Close the brackets and then plus the negative value, which is on year 0. Press the tab key and that should give you 1,402. And you might wonder why we didn't put all the values together for the NPV formula. So instead we added the 0 at the very end here. And the reason for that is if we put all of them together, it would essentially be accounting for year 0 as year 1. And so all the years would actually be misplaced by 1, which isn't quite accurate. So we've got a positive NPV. Now, what does that mean? In short, it means that it's expected to earn a profit, and so you should go ahead and pursue that project. On the other hand, if it's negative, you obviously shouldn't. But usually when we pursue a project, we don't just want the dollar value of it, but we also want the percentage return. And for that, we'll use the IRR, which is short for the internal rate of return. So once on the cell, we'll go equals IRR, press the tab key, and the values are just these values over here. Press enter, and that should give you that 13%. That 13% represents the annual return of the lemonade stand. Now, is that good? Usually you have to compare it versus the discount rate. So if the IRR is greater than the discount rate, that means that the project is expected to be profitable, and so you should go ahead and pursue it. What we just did with the NPV and the IRR is what's known as capital budgeting, and there is a third method to this, which is known as the payback period, which is simply how long does it take to recover the cost of the investment. And companies use these methods to assess whether it's worth pursuing new projects. These projects might range from opening up a new office, a new factory, or even a new product line. So now that it's all dynamic, we can go ahead and change the different scenarios, and everything is going to change with it. As you can see, if we go to the worst case scenario, which is scenario 3, you'll see that all of the figures are actually negative, so we shouldn't go ahead with the project under those assumptions. Alright, so we've determined that this project is viable and we want to go ahead and get started. But we're college students, so we don't have any money, and so we need to go to a bank and ask for a $5,000 loan, which is our base case scenario. And here's the terms that the bank will be offering us. We got a 4-year loan for $5,000 at 5% paid monthly. So to convert everything into monthly, we'll go equals 5% divided by 12, and for the number of payments, it's going to be equals to 4 for the 4 years times 12. Now on the output side, we have some important information that we should know to do with this loan. And so for the monthly payment, we'll go equals PMT, which is short for payment, press the tab key. The rate that we want is the monthly rate, remember? Press the comma key, the number of periods is the 48, press the comma key. The PV is the present value, and so that's $5,000 that they're giving us, so it's a 5,000. And you can see that the FV and the type actually have brackets in them. That means that they're not necessary for this formula to work, and so we'll just close it there because we don't have a future value. Press the enter key. That's a monthly payment of $115. That total monthly payment actually consists of the principal and the interest. If you don't know the difference, the principal is essentially the actual loan amount that you're paying back. So if you borrowed 5,000, how much of that are you paying back each month? While on the other hand, the interest has to do with the fee that they charge for lending you that money, essentially. So let's calculate both of them. And I've just selected a random month in month 24, just so you can see. Equals PPMT, which is going to be for the payment, for the principal. The rate is going to be that same rate. The per here that you can see is actually the period. So in our case, we said we want month 24. Press the comma key. The number of periods is at 48. Press the comma. And the PV is that same 5,000. You can press enter there. That's going to give you the principal paid in month 24. On the other hand, we have the interest. For that, we'll go IPMT. The rate is that same rate here. The periods is 24 again. Press the comma, number of periods is 48. And the PV is just the present value. People usually like to see that breakdown of how much are they paying in principal versus interest. Similarly, sometimes they like to see the total amount of interest that they're going to be paying. For that, you can use this cumulative function. So let's look into that. We'll go equals CUMIPMT, that's the one. The rate is the 0.42 here. Press the comma key. Number of periods is 48. The PV is the 5,000. Comma. The start period is actually the first period because we want the cumulative. So press the comma key there. The last period is the 48. Press the comma key. And then we actually want the end of the period. So we'll press the zero here. Press the close. And there you go. One thing that would be beneficial for us to have is knowing the remaining balance of the loan. So how much have we paid? How much do we need to pay back? And so for that, we'll be using a loan amortization table. So here we got the payment number, which is essentially which period are we in. So we'll go 1, 2, and we'll actually drag it all the way down to 48. Once we got it here, we'll go all the way down. For the payment amount, we're actually going to be equals. We already have it calculated up here, which is the monthly payment. And so we're actually gonna make it negative and select it there. Press the F4 key, press enter. The reason I made it negative is so all the numbers are actually just on positive here. So it's just a lot easier to see. For the interest that we have here, it's just going to be the monthly interest rate, which is the 0.42 times the loan amount, which is going to be 5,000. Press the enter key. The principal is going to be the difference between the payment amount and the interest. So this one minus this one here. And then the remaining balance is going to be equals to the loan amount, which is the 5,000, minus the principal, which is the amount that we've already paid back in period one. For period two, for the payment amount, we can actually just select it and double click it here, and it's going to fill down all the way to the bottom, as you can see by pressing control down and control back up. For the interest, it's going to be equals to the monthly interest rate over here. We're gonna lock it by pressing the F4 key times the remaining balance, because the interest is actually on the remaining balance, it's not on the total amount of the loan. Press the enter key. For the principal, it's going to be the difference, so one minus the other. And then for the remaining balance here, what we're gonna do is equals the current remaining balance minus the principal, press enter. Once we have these, we can select all three and then just double click down here, and it's going to drag them all the way down. Now, if we did this exercise correctly, when we press the control down arrow, it should give us zero as the remaining balance. That is indeed the case, so we did it well. And one final check you can do here is to sum all of the interest payments that you have and see if that's the same as the cumulative interest. So for that, we'll just press equals sum, and we're just going to sum all of these, press the control shift down arrow to get to the bottom, press enter. So that number should be the exact same one as this one. And indeed, that is the case. Very nice. Some other useful Excel formulas include the present value and the future value. And suppose that at the end of university, we want to have $10,000 saved up, as that's the cost of a secondhand car that we want. And so we want to know how much money do we need today to make that happen. And our bank is giving us a 7% interest rate to leave our money there. Now that 7% is not realistic, it's just for this example. So we'll go equals PV, press the tab key, the rate is at 7%, comma, the number of periods is 4 years, comma key, payment, this is the monthly payment that we would be paying. In our case, we're not paying anything monthly, so we'll go 0, press the comma key, and the future value is how much we expect to have in the future, so that's a 10,000. and that equates to around 7,600. So that means that we need about 7,600 to make our car dreams come true in 4 years' time. Similarly, let's say that we want to find out how much this 7,600 would give us in 45 years' time, which is when we hope to retire and eventually buy an even better car, say. So for that, firstly, we're just going to go equals negative 7,629, so just link it here, press the enter key, and for the FV, go equals FV, press the tab key, the rate is a 7%, number of periods is 45 for the years, payment is 0, comma, and the present value is this one here, press the enter key. That gives you 160,000, with which you'll probably be able to buy a decent car, but it is in 45 years' time. If you want to know more about Excel formulas, check out this other video I made over here. And if you want to know more about valuation methods, specifically the discounted cash flow, check out this video over here. That's all for this one. Hit the like, hit the subscribe if you liked it, and I'll catch you in the next one.